So how was your experience of coping with the pandemic, the isolation, not able to meet people? How did you manage that?
In fact, I work in isolation. I think all the world artists work in isolation. Only thing which I missed a lot is being with the community of artists, and you know, socializing with them, going to art exhibitions and things like that, and cinema, theater, music. But I compensated everything by seeing a lot of YouTube programs.
Okay. Mm.
And I educated myself through that in many ways, which I had not otherwise had done it. So in a way, I think, you know, I overcame that. I never felt the thing, accepting the fact that one could not go out, you know, restriction. Otherwise, I didn't have any problem as such.
So, for many of us, the COVID time has opened up a huge digital space. Like how you said, the YouTube are also many webinars for there. Did you attend many of the webinars? And
I did attend one or two webinars, which was done by one gallery.
Mm.
But I felt that online programs are, you know, they're also limited.
Mm.
And they can't really, they've got time restrictions, and you can't really speak a lot there. So it all depends on the organizers, you know, the webinar program, how they form the whole thing, you know. So that way, I think it's okay. Nothing great about it. Yeah.
Hmm. How did this collage practice start? Have you done this before? And
you know, I had done some collage work in 1978, about four of them, which was also selected and exhibited at the National Gallery of Modern Art when I had my retrospective. But I never thought I would continue with collage. And even here also, when I was doing drawings, it happened that, you know, I saw a wedding invitation and I cut them into pieces and started sticking on to the drawing. That led me to collage. Then I saw the four collage work which I had done.
Mm.
And then I was wondering why I had not continued.
Mm.
But then my collage has got the lines coming in, you know, that's very important.
Yeah.
Without the lines, I don't think I can complete the collage work. Not just paper alone. So that's how it is.
So it's a coming together of collage and then your line drawing,
right,
in a certain way.
How? Both collage and line drawing. That's very important for me. Yeah.
So in the collage, I see there are two ways you have approached the work. In some collages, the collage pieces, they are more non-representational pieces. You can't identify the piece that is there. And in some, you can actually make out whether it's a face or whether it's a building. So how do you deal with that two different approaches?
You see, even in my painting, I work from abstraction to, you know, figuration.
Hmm.
From when you see my painting, the first coat of my canvas, completely abstract.
Mm.
And I try to bring in figures later. And something else must have happened that way, you know. But I find that both figuration and abstraction work together in my works.
Mm.
You know, both my paintings and my drawings as well as collages. So there is no difference at all in that way. My approach to that things are like that.
Yeah. So it's a continuation of your...
Yeah.
Practice in painting.
Painting, yeah.
And also, I think because there is a line drawing which is coming on that, it becomes part of the work,
yeah,
and part of the representational figures.
Yeah.
Like if there is a human figure, it becomes part of that. It doesn't remain like a non-representational element.
No. No. In fact, because the line is coming in. Then, when the line comes in, the figure comes in.
Yeah.
You know, I can't do only abstraction. Otherwise, you know, you can stick onto the paper, leave it at that, you know, that I'm not very sure of that. And I have got to bring certain forms. And so that's how I bring it. And I choose such a way that the paper, what I select to stick onto that paper first. It has got already a sort of a shape, which is, you know, which I have got in my mind, how to work within that or around that. That's how I work.
So you have a certain image in mind and then you slowly develop.
And I improvise whenever I improve a lot while I'm doing,
One or two new themes which have appeared in this collage, as I can see. One is the magician, which we had not seen before. And the other is the image of tree and human being combined together, and then a third kind of image is coming up. So how did the magician come out of the box?
The thing is that, you know, magician particularly is my reaction to certain dresses which people wear during their weddings and things like that. Advertisements you can see there. So I thought, why not I use those sort of things? And like what you see here, for example, you know, this whole thing is a nicely kurta pajama dress. But then, at the same time, I want to make some sort of a comedy out of it. It's not just that, you know. So I bring in other elements like the monkey and a bird, which I use normally in my painting, in my drawings. So I bring in this. So I called her not just man, but a magician. That's how I called it, because it's just a man would mean something different.
Correct.
A magician means, you know, he can be creating many things around him, you know, things like that. That's how I called it, magician. And regarding the tree and man, I have done some paintings in my earlier days, a man and tree, in the Vriksha themes. But then here, when I started working, man became more important, you know, for me, more than the tree. Of course, there are some trees here also, but man became more important. And man itself, almost like a tree form, it comes out. That's why I call it man and tree, or man tree, or man dash tree. So it can be a tree dash man, something like that, yeah.
So it's a metaphor for a man becoming a tree and tree, then growth and all.
A tree becoming a man becoming a tree, it's sort of a metaphor, yeah.
Another interesting aspect in these collages, other than using ready images from magazines and invitations, you have treated your own earlier images as a raw material for your collage. Like, for example, here, these are images from your earlier work, which has become part of that. So I think that is also a new...
Yeah, it is. You know, as I was progressing, doing things, cutting from magazines and other things, and I was wondering, why not I use my own images? So that you have seen that coffee table publication, big one. I tore pieces from that and I started using them. And when I started using them, it gave another dimension to the whole thing. It was the same story, but different story altogether, you know. So negative, positive also in some of the works you can see. And I have used, cut the face.
We'll come to that.
And then it's an empty space.
Reflection. Also, they are all from different parts of the painting.
Different parts.
They're not from different one painting.
Not one painting.
Coming together as one.
Yeah. And it's a joy, you know, of doing things, of creating the movement, and of using different color papers, of different things from the book itself or from the otherwise. But mainly, I have used from my book, from my own paintings.
If you look at the whole show, the collages have a feeling of the puppets. Is it any connection to your theater, theater of life series which you have done?
Yeah, you see, the thing is,
they have a sense of a, you know, leather puppet, that kind of feel is there.
You know, Ravi, I have always connected myself with some sort of a Indian craft, you know, and I see puppet as one of the Indian crafts. It's a fantastic craft. And somewhere, you know, I should connect myself with something very local. That's how it works out for me. Otherwise, it becomes very, you know, universal and things like that. It becomes universal, but at the same time, it will have its own, you know.
The roots are in a very local experience.
Very important for me. Very important for me.
Is the deity and the Durga element, which is also not seen so frequently in your earlier work.
But I think in late 60s or early 70s, Air India brought out a calendar. And they had asked about 12 artists to do paintings, gods and their vahanas.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And so I chose Brahma and Hamsa.
Okay.
So I did a series of paintings on that. And then Shiva and Bull and things like that. I did some paintings in 60s, late 60s. I didn't continue that. But then, you know, when I was working on these collages, I was wondering why not I use, you know, that element. Nowadays I see a lot of images of Durga. You know, if you see the YouTube, hundreds of images of Durga comes. So I thought, why not I use Durga in my own way? And you know, the deity also, my own way. It's not like worshipping deity, but
yeah,
you know, it suggests. If not deity, I don't know what else I can call them. You know, so I can call them deity because it's a, it looks like you know, sort of a deity. Yeah.
You are using of your own earlier images as a raw material.
Yeah.
Here I see another dimension has come here. The idea of reflection and the idea of positive negative spaces.
Yeah.
They are presence and absence. So that is also very interesting.
Yeah, that's what I also felt. You know, when I cut the paper, face of a man, face of some human being, then I wanted to use that and see how it works, the negative and positive. First I stuck this, and then I thought, why not I stick the same other side? And then, you know, in between, create a pillar and things happening down. So, I mean, it's a sort of a positive and negative things, which is very interesting for me too. Same thing here also. Here, from some other paper I have cut this, and this is another, some other face. But they are very more or less identical. So I brought in those elements. So it's an interesting thing as you are working, you know.
I see that as a new element, because in your paintings, that very strong positive negative differentiation is not there. One thing merges into another, and you know, it's a very different kind of that fluid spatial relationship is there. Here it's very strongly that positive negative.
It is because the medium itself demands that. The medium cannot, you cannot, in this medium, you cannot be doing anything, excepting that, you know, this portion is very painterly.
Yeah.
You know, when you can just take that much, it can be, look like any of my paintings. But then, I can't just do that. I want to do something else. And this medium demands certain things. And the same medium cannot be applied to painting. Painting is a different medium altogether. And here also, even my drawing, though I use my drawing, the drawing which I do normally is not like this. It's slightly different from what I'm doing.
So now that you have done these collages, when you go back to painting, will there be a new...
I don't know. Quite possible. Something else may come out. Because I've been thinking about these things also, you know, at the same time. And how it would relate, I mean, how it would work when I'm doing painting. And so, I don't know, maybe I'll see. If there's any possibility, I'll do.
This is the collage I was mentioning, where one can recognize the face. But it also becomes part of a larger...
Part of, you know, examples, this... I never thought I would make an animal of a man, but I just stuck this paper first. Then when I was drawing, I stuck this paper in your nose first, then the lips. So it was a very interesting thing to play. One advantage with this collage is it's very interesting to play with the form.
Very unexpected
results come. And one should use those results to make it, you know, yeah. That's very important.
The animal and man images that we see here is also something new in its
field. Yeah, it's sort of, I have done images like monkeys and, you know, birds and things like that in my paintings and drawings. But here, you know, I have used the pets, you know, walking, person walking with a pet. Because you see nowadays, you know, during particularly COVID time, I could see these sort of, you know, people walking around in the building. So I thought I may not use those elements. So I did these things. So it was a very, very interesting thing to work on. And the movement also, you know, I wanted to create a sort of a movement, you know. Here also, a sort of a dancer-like thing, and he's like these people who come in front of the house with the buffalo or a cow, clagged, you know, with sort of a cloth. And adhikiri kannadilla, I don't know.
Then
those people will come and, you know, they demand some money and things like that. So all sort of ideas.
I'm gonna namo da namo da namo da namo namo da namo da tu tu என்னப்பன் அல்லவ என் தாயும் அல்லவ பொன்னப்பன் அல்லவ என்னப்பன் அல்ல